all of you can go places when you start believing in yourself. You all have what it takes in you. Hello everyone, this is Sonitha and welcome or welcome back to Astridelle. In this video, I'm going to be sharing my self-confidence story. The reason that I want to share the story is because I believe that every day is a chance to be someone you weren't yesterday, and my story is a reflection of this very line. I've come a really long way in the last 6 to 7 years. I've transformed from a girl with zero self-confidence to this girl who believes in herself more than anything. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about the reasons for my zero self-confidence, what helped me gain my self-confidence, and what you can do to develop self-confidence. Also, at the end of this video, I have a special thank you note for all those people who've had a significant impact on my life. So stick around until the end of the video, and with that, let's get started. So first off, let's talk about the reasons for my zero self-confidence. Growing up, especially when I was 10 to 12 years old, I often felt isolated by my classmates, and an example of one such incident that made me feel that way was during this games class when a group of girls were playing a game. I walked up to them and I asked them if I could join them in, but they said I couldn't because they were full. But later when another girl came in and asked the same question, they let her join in. While this might have been unintentional on their part, or I could have interpreted the situation in the wrong way, it did have a drastic impact on my life because it made me feel like I wasn't enough and that there was something wrong with me, and that's the reason people didn't really like me. And I often associated this whole feeling with my appearance, which brings us to the second reason for my zero self-confidence. Like most teens growing up, I believed in the people around me more than I believed in myself, and back then I also believed that looks were more important than the person you are. And when people would mock me for the way I looked and make jokes about it, instead of standing up for myself, I would laugh about it in front of them, come back home and cry myself to bed. So I think at that point of time, what I was looking for was validation from others, and I thought I wasn't enough because people didn't think I was enough, or people didn't see I was enough. So I was seeking validation from outside, and that's the reason for my zero self-confidence. Now let's push away all the negativity and focus on what helped me build my self-confidence. So self-confidence isn't really something that just gets built overnight. For some people it might take a few months, and for some people it might take a few years. And when it's happening, you might not realize what's really happening, and only when you look back at it will you realize how small wins have helped you, you know, become more self-confident. So in my opinion, small wins are what are important to build your self-confidence. So let's talk about my small wins. So my first small win was in 7th grade. Just in a few months after moving into this new school in 7th grade, one of my teachers picked me up to be an MC at the Independence Day celebrations. And when she picked me up, I was like, why me? Because I've never done this before. I'm not good with public speaking. I'm not even good with speaking in general. I don't think I can do this. And just a million other reasons as to why I shouldn't be there. But she said, no, it's okay. You got this. You can do this. And on that day, on the day of the Independence Day celebrations, on the stage, I don't really remember if I even messed up that day, but after the event got over, I knew that there was something that I could do, and there was something that I was good at as well, because all this while growing up, I thought I had zero skills, zero talents, and I was just this ordinary girl who could do absolutely nothing in her life. And there suddenly I realized that I can speak well on the stage in front of people, even if it's just my first time. And I think that was a huge deal for me, because knowing that you've got something in you is a huge deal, especially when you think you're not good enough for anything. So that was one win that took up my self-confidence from 0 to 15%. While this might seem a very insignificant difference, it does make a whole lot of difference for someone who has zero self-confidence. So yeah, that was my first win. At this point, I wasn't really good with academics as well, again because of my zero self-confidence. I was scoring C's and D's, but that is a story for another day. But all throughout this time when I was having bad grades, it was my parents and teachers who believed in me when I didn't believe in myself, and always, you know, told me that, Sonitha, you've got this, you have the potential in you to do well, you just have to work harder and put your head and heart into it, and you're just gonna go places when you do that. So I think having those people who believed in me more than I believed in myself had really helped me build my self-confidence all the more. My parents and teachers probably, you know, took my self-confidence up from 15% to like 40 or 50%. But moving on to the next win, my next win was a series of wins in itself. So like most schools, my school had a lot of extracurricular activities as well. And at the end of the year, I would have won at least 3 to 4 activities, both team-based and individual cumulative. And at this point, I was also involved in sports. I was playing both football and basketball. I played basketball for a few months, but I did play football for 2 years. And that is something I really enjoyed doing. And it's something that gave me the confidence that I am good at things that I never thought I would be good at. So yeah, that is another small win for me. So my next small win was in 9th grade. In 9th grade, some of my teachers chose me as a house vice captain, and I'm not really sure how it is in school nowadays, but back then being a vice captain or a captain of a house or even the school was a pretty big deal, and that was something that kind of told me again that Sonitha, there is something you are good at, and when people can see it in you, why can't you really see it in yourself, and why can't you work on yourself? So that is one thing that, you know, kind of told me that I was good with leadership skills, and that was the time I started working on my leadership skills. So in 10th grade, it was an election system, and some of my friends and teachers pushed me to be a candidate for the head girl of the school, and for that, I'm supposed to give a speech asking people to vote for me and just things like that. So when I was on the stage that day, I was not really supposed to have a script in my hand. So it was just a mic in my hand and a script in my head that I'd prepared the previous night. And once I was done with my speech, my academic director and all of my teachers stood up for me and clapped for me, and they hadn't really done it for anyone else. It was a really beautiful moment because it was a thing that I had never expected, and everyone else who gave the speeches was so amazing, and all my teachers and the academic director standing up and clapping for me was a pretty huge deal, and it's something that took up my self-confidence by another 15 or 20%. And that same year, my best friend Aditi and I were chosen to be the MCs at the school sports day. Aditi was a pro at writing and speaking, and I am the one who was supposed to catch up to her. But nevertheless, we had both done really well that day. But what I distinctly remember from that day was how a few of my mom's friends who knew me walked up to her and told her that I had done really well. At this point, I was appreciating myself for how well I had done, but at the same time it also felt really good to know that I wasn't the only one who felt I did really well, but it was also the people around me who felt I did really well. So that was another small win that helped me gain my self-confidence a lot more. And again that year, like I had mentioned that I wasn't really good with academics in 7th grade, my 10th grade results were really good, and that helped me become a lot more self-confident with respect to my academics. But along this whole journey of small wins, there was one thing constant, and what was constant was the people who had my back and people who believed in me when I didn't believe myself. These were the people who pushed me towards opportunities and were always there to help me when I struggled and when I had self-doubt. But there was a time when I didn't really have anyone to push me and, you know, be there for me at that point of the time, and that was in college. So when I got into the college in July 2019, I knew that I wanted to be a part of the one of the two clubs that were meant for the first year students. And the reason that I wanted to be a part of a club was because for me, extracurriculars were just as important as academics to develop my skills, and I had learned that from all the years before. So now, to be an executive member of one of the clubs, you had to go through a selection process. And this selection process was happening in two ways. One, you could sign up on the Google Forms and fill in everything they ask you and answer all your questions there. Or two, you can go onto the stage and answer a few questions that the last year's club members were gonna ask you. Or you could do both of them just in case you want to try your luck at both. Now, I had already filled in the Google Forms because I was a little skeptical about going onto the stage. Like I said before, there was no one to push me forward to go onto the stage. But nevertheless, I'm like, what is the point of having done so much and coming such a long way to just not go onto the stage because I am scared? So I pushed myself, I signed up to go on the stage, and I was the second person to go onto the stage. I was asked a few questions, and these few questions were to be answered in front of 1200 new students. All of us were first years and I did not know any one of them. I was a little bit scared of people judging me, but then I told myself no one's even going to remember me after this whole thing is over. So I just went on the stage, I answered a few questions, and then they asked me what my talents were, and I was faced with that question because I have zero talents. Honestly, even now I have zero talents. So I gave a very bad answer. The answer was, I have no talents, I only have organizing talent, which is completely, entirely wrong. And I'm like, what did I do? I came back down, I googled if organization was a talent, because I was like, what an answer was that? And it said, no, it's a skill. And then I'm like, okay, it's a skill. And somehow this whole on the stage speaking selection process got cancelled, and there were selections held all over again for the same set of people in classrooms. So the selections was not in front of 1200 students, but only in front of people who wanted to be a part of the club. So then they asked me to introduce myself. I didn't really have much to introduce about myself, because even today when you ask me to introduce myself, I kind of wonder what details should I include. But when they said that, I kind of started off on a note that my senior said on the stage that day. She said, when you've got something in you, when you've got a certain skill or talent in you, don't keep it to yourself thinking it's going to be boasting. You are not boasting. It's called self-branding. And that had really moved me, because I'm like, damn, that's such a nice way to put things. So I started off with that. I said, so this is what my senior said, and I really think it's so true, and that's the reason I'm going to say what I'm going to say now. So I went ahead and I talked about how I was a vice captain and all of that. And then I said, I wasn't really happy with the answer I gave on stage that day. So here's my answer to the question, what talents do I have? I have zero talents. I only have skills. And that was such a good answer, because I was so happy with it. That like took my self-confidence to a whole different level. And a lot of people came up to me after that and they're like, what an answer was that? And I'm like, thank you. I didn't realize it was going to be that good. But I think that was the first time when I was self-confident without people around me, and that makes me really proud. Now, coming to the results of those selections, I was not just an executive member, but I was selected as a vice president of one of the clubs, and that really makes me proud. So this is the badge that constantly reminds me of how far I've come. It is something that I achieved without having anyone to push me. I pushed myself and I took that step to go onto the stage and speak that day. And if I did not do that, if I was just afraid of going onto the stage and speaking in front of a bunch of strangers, I probably wouldn't have this badge today, and I probably wouldn't have developed the skills that I have developed over the last few months. So this was a really, really big win for me, and this was the first time that my self-confidence came into play without having to do anything with the people around me or having to do anything with people supporting me. So it's something that I'm really proud of. But this is how self-confidence gets built and finally comes into action. It was small wins that stacked up over the time and made a difference over the time. One of these wins wouldn't have probably made a difference individually, but only when you put all these wins together, you realize how much each of these wins have affected your life. And these small wins are what's important to develop your self-confidence over the time. So now, what can you do to build your self-confidence over the time? So if you're a person who's starting out at 0% self-confidence like I did a few years ago, the first thing you have to do is eliminate negative talk. This is something all of us have done to ourselves at some point in our life. All while I was growing up, I brought in so much negativity into my life with small statements that I made. We often find ourselves making negative statements like, oh, I can't do this, I'm going to fail this exam, it's too difficult, it's not my cup of tea, and I'm not good at this, and just, you know, a series of negative statements like this. When you are making negative statements like this, you might think it does not affect you, but it does affect you in a way you won't even think it will. And over the time, these negative statements will pile up and make you feel like you're not good at something that you are positively good at. So once you've eliminated the self-talk, start by saying positive things to yourself. This is what I do when I feel like I can't do anything right and I'm just not able to do things and I'm in a very panicky mode. So what I do is I tell myself a series of these statements that helps me get back on track and helps me get out of my panic mode into a more zen mode. So I say this to myself, Sonitha, you've got this. I know you can do this, and I know that you have what it takes in you to get this thing done in the best way possible. So when I say this to myself, I am not bringing down my own confidence. I am, you know, boosting my self-confidence and believing in myself that I can get the work done in the best way possible. So this is what you can tell yourself when you're in a panicky mode and when you just feel like nothing's going right and it's just a really difficult situation for you. So the next thing you should do after repeating these statements to yourself is to visualize yourself to be the person you want to be in the future. This is really helpful when you're scared of taking that one step that could lead to a small win. Like I've mentioned in my story earlier, I was really skeptical to go onto the stage in front of 1200 students in college. But what really pushed me onto the stage that day was the fact that I saw myself as a public speaker in the future, and I knew I wanted to be a good public speaker in the future. And going onto the stage that day would give me a small win in the journey of becoming a good public speaker. And if I didn't go onto the stage that day, I probably would have regretted it today and regretted missing an opportunity. And that is what actually pushed me onto the stage that day. This next step is very, very important to build your self-confidence. It is to let go of the fear of judgment. This is basically when you go, oh my God, if I mess up, are they gonna laugh at me? What if I mess up? What are they going to think about me? Are they going to judge me? And what are they going to say about me? And just, you know, a series of these thoughts that involve the world. Darling, focus on yourself. Don't restrict your growth because of what people might say. Even if you mess up, the world's going to forget it in a few months or years, if not a few days and weeks and even a few hours. Trust me, I'm saying this because I know it. I've been there. I've done it. And even I don't remember the mistakes I've made on the stage. So these small things about what people would think about you are things that will restrict you from growing. So don't let it restrict you from growing. Don't let the world get to you. You are enough, and just keep telling that to yourself that I am enough. I've got this. I can do this to the best of my ability. And trust me, you're gonna go places when you say that to yourself. This next step is just as important as the previous step. It is to let go of the fear of the outcome. This is basically when you're scared about what would happen if you take that one small step. My suggestion would be to stop doing it, because I've been there and I had this fear of failure with respect to my academics, and I felt like, what if I fail? I would be, you know, bringing down the expectations of my parents, my teachers and the people around me, and led to me performing bad in turn. And this is something you might not realize that you're doing to yourself, because I realized this after I read a story about a girl who did this to herself, and I realized that I was doing the same thing to myself. So the first thing to do is to let go of what might happen if you do this and focus on the process. I even have this quote stuck in big letters on my door. It says, focus on the process, not on the outcome. And doing this has helped me grow as a person a lot more. And try focusing on the process as much as possible and stop focusing on things that are not in your control. And even if you mess up, it's okay. Like I've mentioned earlier, no one's gonna remember it except you. Everyone has their own life and everyone has their own set of things happening in their life. And I'm sure not a lot of people really have the time to think about what you've messed up, how you've messed up and all of those things. So yeah, let go of the fear of failure or the fear of outcome and just focus on the process and not the outcome. So these are the four steps that have helped me build confidence and push my limits over the time. Only when I push my limits did I actually grow in life, and I did not really realize that, okay, this is what I'm doing and this is how it's helping me. But only now that I look back at all those times, I realize that these are the things that have helped me gain my self-confidence. But this person you're seeing on your screen today, I wasn't this person a few years ago, to be precise, 7 years ago, and I am this person today only because of these bunch of people in my life. So that brings us to this thank you note that I want to, you know, put at the end of this video. It's like a little thank you speech, because I'm not very good with expressing my emotions directly to them. So this is going to be my way of conveying it to them. So first off, I'd like to thank my parents. My parents are literally the best parents I could ever have. They've never scolded me over a bad grade. All they would say is, we know you can do it. We know you've got the potential in you. Just work harder and try better next time. And it means a lot to me to have them trust in me and to have them believe in me when I did not believe in myself. And that was just really important to me at the time when I felt like really low. And I know that we don't say this very often, but Amma and Nana, I'm very thankful to have you in my life, and I'm so glad you are my parents. And I also know that we don't say this to each other, but I love you both a lot, and thank you so much for always being there for me and, you know, just supporting me and letting me experiment and make my mistakes and learn from my mistakes. And thank you for just not stopping me from doing anything that I wanted to do. So thanks a lot once again. I love you both, and I can't be grateful enough to have you both in my life. So yeah, that is for you if you're gonna watch this video this far. And then this next thank you note is for my sister Deepu. Deepu, sorry for the being that person I would come and scold and remove all my anger on when I'm not really feeling well. But when I did have my moments of low self-confidence and moments of bad days, you were that one person who would take all the scoldings without saying a word. And I think that would, that like really helped me let go of all that, what do you call, all that negative feeling and anger and irritation inside me. So yeah, thank you so much, Deepu. And I'm like really sorry because I keep screaming at you, but know that you are really important in my life. The next thank you note is for all my teachers who have made a significant impact on my life. Again, I'm not sure if they're going to be watching this video, but if you do, my math teacher Sailata ma'am, my physics teacher Shakila ma'am, my chemistry teacher Geeta ma'am, and all of the other, oh, my English teacher Vijaya ma'am, and all of the other teachers who I might have missed out, you all have had a very significant impact on my life. And trust me, if not for you, I wouldn't be this person today. You've teamed up with my parents in every PTM, and you kind of tried to make me understand that I could do it and I had what it takes in me to be good at whatever I do. And you, along with my parents, have helped me realize my true potential. And I think the person I am today, I owe it to all of you, because you all were more of a friend to me than a teacher, and you were just always there for me when I needed you. All of you have seen me cry, you've seen me laugh, you've seen me been crazy, you've seen me get punished, and it's just so beautiful to think about all those moments again. But thank you so much for being there in my life and making such a significant impact on my life. I'm not even exaggerating, but you all have literally changed my life around, and I can't be grateful enough to have found this amazing bunch of teachers in my life. And thank you so much for believing in me when I didn't believe in myself, and pushing my limits and constantly telling me I could do things and I could go places. Thank you so much. This next thank you note is for my best friend Aditi. Aditi, I met you in 8th grade, and needless to say, you've been a great support system since then, and you've helped me grow in just so many ways. You've always told me to believe in myself and not really think about what people would think about me and what they would say about me. And I think that's the best part about you. You're always there for me, even if you're not a call away, but I know that you're always there for me. So thank you so much, and I'm so grateful to have you as a best friend in my life. And then my next thank you note is for these bunch of amazing people I met in 11th and 12th grade. Jansi, Purni, Janet, and Saryu. You guys might not realize, and you might not realize how, and you might be wondering how, but you have had a significant impact on my life, because you are the people I could be myself with, and you've helped me accept myself to be the person I am and not really care about what people want to see me as. So thank you so much for making 2 years fun and, you know, being there for me when I needed you guys. You guys are amazing, and I can't wait to meet you all again. This next thank you note is for everyone watching this video and everyone who's been watching my videos and supporting my Instagram page ever since I started out. You all have been amazing support systems. You've constantly noticed small improvements I was making in my videos and motivated me and told me ways I could improve my content in, and that really improves my self-confidence, and it tells me that, okay, this is another thing I'm good at, and I can make more meaningful content, and I know that this is something I really like doing. And you know, it just gives me lots of confidence and, you know, lots of positivity to hear things from all of you. So a huge thanks to everyone who's been there on this journey, YouTube journey, with me ever since I started. And also a huge thanks to all of you who just joined me recently. You all are amazing people, and know that you can go places when you believe yourself and know that you are enough. So a huge thanks to everyone watching this video and everyone who's supporting my channel and Instagram ever since I started up. This last thank you note is for all those people who've mocked me, who've, you know, kind of put me down and brought in a lot of negativity into my life. You've helped me learn to become a stronger person. You've helped me learn to deal with the negativity that comes my way, and you've taught me lessons that I wouldn't learn otherwise. So a huge thank you to all of you who've, you know, made me a stronger person and taught me lessons that are much required, and I wouldn't learn otherwise. So once again, a huge thank you. So yeah, that was my little too long thank you speech, but making this whole video has given me a more positive perspective into my life. It has reminded me of how grateful I should be for all the things that I've had in my life, and it has also given me the opportunity to be grateful for all of that and thank all those people who brought in a change into my life. And at the same time, another thing that it reminded me of is how all those negative things that have happened in my life are having a very insignificant or negligible impact in my life today, whereas all that positive things that have happened and all those small wins have really amounted up to have a significant change in my life. And that's like a reminder to focus on the positivity and not the negativity, and just don't be afraid of, you know, failure or judgments, and don't restrict yourself because of your fears. Let yourself grow and focus on the positivity, and trust me, you all are enough and all of you can go places when you start believing in yourself. You all have what it takes in you. Just like me, you probably have to realize that you've got it in you and tell yourself you've got it in you, because everyone has it in them to, you know, do things that they want to and be good at anything they want to be good at. So yeah, that was my self-confidence story, and this is the first life lesson video on our channel. I really hope you enjoyed it and found it helpful. Do let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see more life lesson videos like this, where I talk about what I've gone through and how I've dealt with it, or what I am going through right now and how I'm dealing with it. So yeah, do leave the comments below, and until the next video, bye.